Hi everybody, in this tutorial I'm going to introduce your Raster data model in GIS. Raster data model abstracts the real world or feature class by a grid of cells. They are matrix of numbers organized in columns and rows, and each cell only represents a single value, also known as a gray value. To better understand Raster data model, let's practice the concept in ArcGIS. So first of all, open up your ArcMap. And then navigate to lab 4 folder and find raster folder. Close. And then navigate to lab 4 folder, add data, folder connection, DSPC, H, GIS labs, okay, lab 4 data, and find raster data set. So in this folder there are two raster data sets. So these are raster, so you can see it's kind of like a grid. This one and this one are raster data sets, and also we have a vector data set shapefile, a type of vector data model. So first add the boundary of Ohio, county of Ohio, into ArcMap, and then click add data and load the digital elevation model of Ohio. Click add. Close. To see the digital elevation model, we need to change the order of layer in table of content. So if I put digital elevation model on top of the county, I can see the digital elevation model of Ohio. So this is the digital elevation model of the study area, which shows elevation of Ohio for each location. So it's a, as you can see, it's a continuous surface. It's not like point line polygon, because in every location we have elevation, right? So let's zoom in multiple times, so until we can see some pixels, okay, or cells. Each of these cells, however they cover an area, they only have a single value or a single color, which represents elevation for that location. In order to see elevation for example, this location, we can use identify button. So I use identify and then click on that. So you can click any location in this cell. You can see that the pixel value is 323. So and if I click any location on this cell, it shows the same value, okay? So elevation of this pixel is 323 meters. Question 1, how we can identify pixel size or spatial resolution? As you know, smaller pixel size, better resolution and more details. So how can I find the pixel size of this raster dataset? If you right click on the raster dataset in table of content, properties, and then source tab, here you can see that the cell size for X and Y is 1000 1000, and the unit is based on meters, okay? So each pixel corresponds to 1000 meters underground, and it covers 1000 meters times 1000 meters, or 1 kilometer times 1 kilometer, so which is 1 square kilometer underground. So how many pixels, how many rows and columns are in this raster? So in order to see the number of rows and columns, so that's number of columns, we have 443 column and 506 rows. So again, a spatial resolution is 1000 meter. It's obvious that if we had a digital elevation model with cell size of 30 meters, we definitely would have more number of columns and more number of rows. And on the other hand, we had a larger volume. This one is 400 kilobyte, but sometimes if you have a better spatial resolution. Maybe it's more than 100 megabyte and so. So when you have a larger volume of data, or a bigger data, or a bigger raster data set, so it requires longer time for loading in ArcGIS. So let's change the color of this DEM. You have to go to the symbology tab, and here go to the stretch because it's a continuous surface, and then select a color ramp, for example. This one is better. So here you can see variation of elevation in Ohio. So here we have higher elevation, the red color, and in these areas we have lower elevation. We can also compare it with base maps. As you know, as you remember, base maps were built-in maps in ArcGIS. So from add base map, we can select imagery, or imagery with labels better because it has the label or the name of the location. So click add. So here is Ohio, and then if you zoom in, you can see the name of the locations and compare it with the ground truth or reality, okay? So again, it's a raster data sets, and here, for example, we have lower elevation because it's closer to the Lake Erie. And in these areas also we have lower elevation close to the Ohio River, which makes sense. So right click on the digital elevation model and then zoom to layer. So again, digital elevation is a matrix of cells or numbers to represent elevation for a continuous surface. So it's ideal for field features, okay. Now let's add another raster from lab 4 folder with the name of Landcover Ohio. So add data, Landcover OH, then close. Again, you need to change the order of the layer and put the Landcover on top of the county to see the layer. Or you can just change the color to hollow and then okay. So this raster shows different type of land covers in Ohio. I obtained this from National Land Cover Dataset for the year 2016. That's the latest version of land cover in the United States. So if you open up attribute table of land cover of Ohio, right click, open attribute table. Each row in attribute table corresponds to a collection of cells with similar value. If you remember, in vector data model, or such as shapefile, each row corresponds to one location or one feature on the map, right? But here, each row in the raster dataset corresponds to a collection of cells with a similar value, okay? For example, all of these selected cells represent value of 11. Okay, all of these selected cells, and also here we also have some selected cells. So to understand the name of each category, you can easily search National Land Cover. So if you haven't, open up your browser and type National Land Cover Data NLCD National Land Cover 2016 legend. Okay, so you have to look at the legend to understand the name of each value, and then select the first one, National Land Cover Database 2016 legend. So here you can see that the value of 11 shows open water, and also here is the definition: areas of open water generally with less than 25% cover of vegetation or soil, okay. And also 21 shows developed open space and so forth. An application of land cover data in public health is the study of vector-borne disease, which are highly dependent type of land cover. For instance, a factor that can have influence on the occurrence of diseases can be proximity to forest. Okay, so we have a different type of forest information: deciduous forest, evergreen forest, mixed forest. So 41, 42, 43. Okay, so we have, for example, we know the forests are here. So we can calculate, we can consider or add another variable such as proximity to forest, proximity to open water, proximity to different type of land cover, and incorporate it as a new variable in our model or future analysis. So let's look at the cell size of this land cover. If you right click on the land cover properties in the source tab, we can see the cell size is 30 meter by 30 meter, which means that each cell equals to 30 meter underground. Okay, it has a better spatial resolution compared to the digital elevation model that we just saw. So we're going to calculate area of each category of land cover based on the cell size. Okay, so open attribute table of land cover Ohio, and then if you clear selections, so we're going to add a new field with the name of area a square kilometer, and then calculate the area for each category. Okay, so add a new field with the name of area underscore a square kilometer. Okay, so we have to, yeah, this one has to make sense because in the future maybe we want to see the areas. So how can I understand that this is not a square miles? Okay, so I have to call it with a good name. Okay, so and the type of double, click OK. So as you know how we can do some calculations on the fields using field calculator, right click on the header and then field calculator, then yes. So here you can write the query. And what is the area of each pixel in a square kilometer? So each pixel is 30 meters, right? So which is 0.03 kilometer. And then times, again, 0.03 kilometer. So that's the area of each pixel based on kilometer. And how many pixels do we have? So we have to count it by, time it, multiply it by count, right? So that's the area of each pixel, and this is the total number of the pixels for each category. So then click OK. So we have the area for each category, and you can also add another field with the name of, for example, name of the category and type open water and so forth. So here we can see that for, if I sort the value ascending or descending, so this value 82, which is cultivated crops, areas used for the production of annual crops such as corn and so forth, so this one has the largest area of land cover in Ohio. If I select that one, we can see that in the western part of the Ohio we have this type of land cover. Okay, so raster data are very common in GIS. Other examples are temperature, humidity, precipitation, population density, or satellite images products such as vegetation cover, land surface temperature, or sea surface temperature, and so forth. So we can download these data and then we can link these variables to the public health problem or other applications, and use them in ArcGIS to better monitor occurrence of the diseases, to